people throwing express 1.5 inch extended bump stops. Take your old bump stop out of your bump stop tube, and I'm just going to put a little white lithium grease on here and get it up in there. And this is for if you're running bigger tires and you don't want to bottom out your longer shocks, and or so you don't bottom your tire out in your fender well or in your fender and crumple your fender all up. So just get a little white lithium grease on there. It's a little hard to get up in there, but I just put it up in there, start twisting till I know it's fully seated up in there. And then I may even get a mallet and whack on it just to make sure it's all the way up in there. And that's how you install that. Okay, the next thing I want to show you guys is, you know, we got the bump stop in there. I just took a mallet, smacked it up in there, and seated up in there nice, and you can't pull it out easily. So if you have that, usually these are only like about a 1 inch to 1.5 inch longer. And like me, I'm running 35s on 5.5 inches of lift. So I'm wanting to get as much down travel as possible and limit my up travel, because I don't want to bottom out these shocks. So I'm trying to extend the length of the shock and shorten it so it doesn't bottom out without changing the mounting location of the shock and all that. So you go out and you get you some hockey pucks. What you'll do is you'll drill a hole in the center of these. I've got 3 of them here. And I'm going to drill a hole through all of these. And then where your coil spring seat is, where the bottom of your coil spring mounts on your axle, you'll drill that hole out and then you'll tap it and run your bolt through all these, and those will set right up on that, like that. What that'll do is that'll make sure this bump stop contacts earlier. So you can adjust it. You can run 1, 2, 3, 4, however many you want to run. I'm probably going to end up using 3 from what I've been figuring. So that's what I'm going to do. Let's go get these drilled out, get some hardware, and get this on here. Now, if you want to find out how many hockey pucks you need, what you do is you lift the truck up, Jeep up, and put some jack stands on the body side, take your coil springs out, take your shocks off the bottom, and then just kind of set your shocks off to the side out of the way, and get you a jack under one side, and you know, make sure both shocks are off, everything's kind of free hanging. Put your tire back on if you're wanting to measure how far it'll go before it contacts the fender. And then, you know, just, I got a block of wood here because this jack doesn't have very high jacking. It doesn't go up very far. So get the shocks off, get the tire on, and you just jack it up until you get to where you think it needs to be. See, I've still got a lot of room in the fender, which I'm not worried about. I'm more worried about the shock. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to measure the center line of this eyelet here to right where that, there's a little rubber kind of bump stop on the shock itself to keep the shock from actually bottoming out real hard. So I'm going to measure from there up to that, and then probably add about a 1/2 to 3/4 inch onto that. And then I'm just going to measure from the shock body down to where the mounting surface of that is, figure out how much or how many hockey pucks I need, and then drill that many out, put them on there, put the coil springs back on, put the shocks back on, we're ready to go wheeling. Okay, just so you can see what we got here, we got 3 hockey pucks, and that's what it's going to look like. You know, your coil spring goes all the way up there, down there. So that's where it'll first start contacting, and since that's kind of like a polyurethane,
there's not going to be a whole lot of deflection. So I set mine right really close, within like a quarter inch of perfect. And what I was telling you about is, you want to measure from that shock body there. See right there where it's at? The bottom of the shock itself. Here, let's go around here. See right there? You're going to measure from right there down to where it actually mounts on the axle. And I'm at 3.5 inches. And that's because I'm going to be running these TerraFlex bar pin eliminators. And those are going to give me more down travel, about an inch. So that's about perfect for me. And then, just so you can see how much fender I have left, I've got, I don't know, probably a good solid 4.5 inches there. So nothing's going to contact up in here. The tire's cleared for the inner fender well and the outer fender. So that should work just fine for me. Okay, so for those of you who don't know me, if I don't have the right stuff, I make shit work. So what I did, instead of actually drilling and tapping the coil spring bucket, I didn't have the correct drill bit for the 3/8 inch tap. So what I did was I just took a 3/8 inch lock nut, not a nylon lock, just a lock nut, and I drilled out the hole to the diameter of the nut itself, the overall diameter of the nut, and then I just weld it around it and ground it smooth, and I'll show you that now. Hope you guys can see that. But that's pretty much what I did. So just goes to show you, if you don't have the right stuff, you can make stuff work. It's just thinking outside the box and actually being able to get stuff done.
So here's what I did. I drilled the hole out just larger, just barely, it's barely larger than the nut. And I'm using a step drill bit, so only half of this metal is the same size as the nut. So what I did was I tap on the top of this bolt with a hammer until it sits flush, and then I'll go ahead and weld this around and then grind it all smooth, and then it'll be permanent.
Well, there you go, guys. Hope this was helpful, and we'll see you in the next one.